Up through the gears they go. We're racing at Talladega Super Speedway.
And you see it already how that restart was going with Chase. He's already down low. The 48's already in front. William Byron, they had that plan from the get-go.
That second row just laid back. Now it's the moment Jimmy Johnson just laid back and kind of drug the field and gave themselves a place to go.
I love their single file. And we got a lot of Fords there behind them. Will they organize? Will they get together and try to take over and beat these Chevrolets? That's really what it's going to come down to today.
Yeah, right now, this time of the race, Clint Boyer pushing Keselowski, trying to get a big run on the outside. These drivers are learning. They have not been in a pack like this all weekend long. They don't know if this outside is going to work well or not. Right now, it seems to be working pretty well.
Teaming up, Ford's on the outside. There's a Chevrolet tucked in there as well with Kyle Larson. But right now, here they come. You see the manufacturers, 18 of them are Chevrolets, 15 Fords, and 7 Toyotas, and the Fords just push to the front, and we see Keselowski up front.
And a great job by Keselowski right there. Dragging is great, keeping Clint Boyer hooked to him to get that lead. That you cannot just sit in that car wide, run wide open. You gotta drag that brake and keep the car hooked up to you.
And Boyer took the bottom groove there, pulled down in front of the Chevrolet of the Chase Elliott. That's gonna hurt this 22 car here, but that's the choice that Clint had to make. He knew that if he didn't get down in front of that 9 car, that the 9 of those were gonna go right back by them on the inside. Good move to take control of that bottom lane.
It's 3 wide now. You see Logano leading that outside line, almost coming down into the 3 of Austin Dillon.
And look at the move that Kyle Busch has made. He did not qualify well, started toward the back. He has made up 10 spots already in the middle lane.
All right, we'll see who's able to get onto pit road cleanly.
Oh, Blaney,
and not everyone's coming.
Blaney got it there.
Oh, here goes Blaney around. Spins as he comes onto pit road, into the grass. Will it bring out a caution?
If he gets his fire, this thing fired up, I don't think it'll bring out a caution. He's rolling, but that'll be big. He is going to lose the draft right here.
Final lap of stage one. They're side by side as they go across the stripe and into one. William Byron has the help of teammates behind him. Joey Logano, a 3-time winner at this racetrack, has Ricky Stenhouse Jr. and Brad Keselowski right behind him.
William needs to get down there and side draft that 22 and then move away from him. He has some help going. No help for the 22, though. The 17's moved away from him.
Yeah, the 22 trying to side draft. He did a good job of stalling those guys out just for a moment.
24 has the momentum. Is he going to be able to stay in front?
Block. A lot of information from your spotter. You need right here. Which lane do you need to block?
Down there.
Remember, the start-finish line is further down this racetrack than it is every other.
And the momentum's coming on the bottom.
At the Triumph, William Byron goes to the double yellow line. Coming out of the Triumph, William Byron's going to win stage one. They were 4 wide behind him for position.
Yeah, well, we got word right now that they're actually going to call this race today. Not going to be able to get the track dry in time. It takes about 2.5 hours to dry this track. We got sunset around 6:15, so that won't give us time to finish the race. And NASCAR was, if they're going to restart a race, they want the ability to get to the end, to get to the checkered flag. Not going to be able to do that today. So what time tomorrow you think, Rick?
We're going to race at 2 p.m. Eastern time. It'll be on NBCSN. So it is postponed. And that means that we will continue where we left off. So the end of stage one will be complete. They will be able to go through their pit stops when the green flag comes back, or it'll be the yellow flag, but when it comes back out tomorrow, and then we will try to get to the conclusion of this race. It's 188 laps, it's 500 miles, and the first 55 laps were pretty entertaining. Cars jumping out of line. One of those being the 2 of Brad Keselowski back there. The white number 2.
Even more cars going to that top. Larson jumping up in front of that train. Now he's in the middle. 3 wide. Already down the back straightaway. Very similar to stage one. I thought these guys might take it easy, but looks like the race is going to be the same as it was yesterday.
They've been thinking all night about what they could have done different, what they could have done better, what they learned. Now they're ready to go.
Oh, Byron goes up in front of his teammate, gets out of that bottom groove to go pick up his teammate, William Byron. Everybody did a great job there. He's using the brakes and the pits. Keep themselves out of trouble.
trouble. That was a really late block from Chase Elliott. I think fortunate to get away with that.
How about Alex Bowman in the 88?
Oh,
he gets a shove. He's going to go sideways right in front of the pack. The 48 caught him, but if the 9 is caught him, the caution has come out. He got a big shove right into the front of the pack. The 42 of Kyle Larson, he is there. The 11 is caught up. And flames coming out from underneath the 48 of Jimmy Johnson.
Here you go right here. 22 being pushed. Goes to the inside. Alex tries to block. They make contact. Round Alex goes. That's what we're talking about with blocking. You know, blocking is one of the things you have to do. You also have to know when you can't do it. But if you don't block, you're not going to win this race.
In the field, coming through the tri-oval again, under caution. But that will end stage two. And as you mentioned, Bowyer is going to win the stage. It's Keselowski and Bowyer, one and two. They made up the front row, and Blaney behind the two. So teammates working together on that high line. We'll see if the Fords all fall into line. William Byron right in the middle of that, in that 24.
One thing that happened in that wreck is there was a lot of Chevrolets in it. You know, a lot of Chevrolets working together. Well, a lot of them got in that wreck. Bowman, Johnson, Larson. Of course, we don't know the damage yet. Chase Elliott's car.
Joe Logano continuing to push. And he shoves the 24. William Byron.
Cars going through speed and drive there. Yeah, William Byron now at the front is the lone Chevrolet. Dillon and a few other cars out in his pack, but lost his teammates in that crash.
You see Clint Bowyer in that 14 car right in the thick of things, and he's been animated on the radio. He got into the wall a minute ago. Have a listen. Okay, and his spotter, Brett Griffin, reassuring him, I don't see any smoke. They think he might be okay. His pit crew kind of sprung into action for a minute, but they seem a little bit more relaxed here. And there you see him getting into the wall.
He almost sounds out of breath, too, when he was saying that. Under green flag conditions.
You're going 200 miles an hour, three wide. He's
out of breath, too, really.
He's holding his breath.
Yes.
In this action, man, I'm telling you.
He jumped in the middle, went with Eric Almirola into the middle, and that move is not working for Clint Bowyer.
I just don't know that I've seen guys race this hard, this much. I mean, through each stage, the first stage, second stage, and now the third stage, we rarely, if ever, have seen the teams race two, three wide the entire day.
Yellow's out.
And so the caution has come out with 36 laps to go. And everyone catching their breath. There is the 14 of Bowyer. He is high centered.
This is big trouble.
Right,
oh no. It's stuck. Oh, that is huge.
I'll blow it up. I can see you. They're going to have to push you. Rear wheels are off the ground.
He's about to take the lead. It's 22.
Oh, he got
push it hard. 17 does a good block.
The 38 had some momentum with the 22 pushing. He jumps up in front of that outside line. Now the inside line falls back.
Three forwards and outside line organized to push and help each other.
Oh, and around goes the 22. A hard hit by Joe Logano.
Right,
the 41. Logano was running in the second position up there on the outside line.
Third tire blew out on the 22 car. How fast things change here.
Suspension. The hood's up. It doesn't look terrible. Grant to me, we'll get that tape down. Erbon, get the backing off of it, guys.
Just to the 41.
That's red 41.
Look at all this inside. That's boom from the door.
Boom, boom. Three or four of them all together.
Right in the look out. 22 almost went over.
Yeah, that's a moment that all the safety of the roof flaps and the hood flaps definitely save that 22 car.
This front lane right now with all the chaos behind them, they're gonna wanna stay single file. They're gonna try to separate themselves
from that, from about 12th on back.
And look at who's in this line right now. Kurt Busch, Matt DiBenedetto, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., David Reagan, Kevin Harvick, Daniel Hemric, Michael McDowell. They're the top seven right now here in Talladega.
Now there's another car losing one of those hood flaps, 38. David Reagan, they're going to be hood flaps all over the racetrack. Everybody's having trouble with those.
It looks like it's connected to the car. It is. There's a tether on it to try to keep it on the race car.
The 95 of DiBenedetto also has that same issue.
Don't give up on Brad Keselowski either. He's back about 8 or 10 cars, but continues to work the top with the 10 of Almirola behind him. You see him back there.
Yeah, that's Blaney, the 12 car.
Watch Kyle Busch. Kyle Busch keeps looking to that outside. He's watching that car on the outside. The white car, Blaney. The minute he gets momentum, there he goes. He keeps wanting to get in that outside lane, thinking he can lead it.
I had Brandon Ehrenberg, and then you mentioned it. Blaney jumped up. Now the 18's up there. The numbers are increasing.
Michael McDowell's not going to go with the 94.
He did not go. I was really surprised. But here comes the 12 of Blaney. Up behind the 18. And look, a 4.
DiBenedetto gets shuffled out.
17. And he's going to the bottom for the lead.
Ricky Stenhouse Jr. surges to the front.
Here comes Benedetto back on the inside. Big block by Stenhouse. That helped the one car. Now can the car behind the one get him?
Into the left rear corner around the one car. Almost turned the one car around right there.
But David Reagan using a lot of patience there to push the one car rather than jump up on the outside of him.
Ricky Stenhouse Jr., two car length lead. Now, when they come back to him, how hard will the hit be from DiBenedetto? Or will he leave him hanging? Will he try to take the lead away?
Further back, you see Keselowski, that white car, trying to make it three wide on the outside.
Really loose through the trouble, getting the shove to the 38. Man, the pushes are intense. To the outside of the 17 goes Kurt Busch.
Ricky Stenhouse Jr. stays to the inside line. Now Kurt Busch to the lead.
And quite clear.
To the outside lane. That three wide outside. Here it comes. Brendan Gaughan leading it.
Now the 18 jumps up there. Take over that. He's going to get some help. That'll take a little bit of energy out of that energy. That middle through.
Three wide for the lead. Here comes the 18 on the high side. Pushes. In the second and third lane, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. on the bottom. Three wide through the triangle.
What's Kyle Busch going to do right here? He's got the lead. Is he going to stay up top?
I think he has to. As long as that momentum's there, keep it.
Look how far he's jumping out in front, though. Can't block three lanes when they catch him. One car sideways.
Kurt Busch is all over the place right now. Now the 18 drops down to the bottom. He'll block the inside line.
What a tough spot for Kyle Busch. What lane's he going to block? The outside lane. Now the inside lane's going to come.
Here comes the inside lane. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. back to the front. Another hood flap flies off.
Oh,
here comes the 18. The four. The 62 upside down. Brendan Gaughan upside down as he went back in front of the pack.
We're wrecked here, guys.
And the big one happens right at the front of the field.
That was crazy. Brendan Gaughan just flipped around, fortunately landed on his tires.
The two, major damage.
Why drivers' heart rates are through the roof on these late race restarts. Kurt pushing Kyle.
He just hooked him.
Brendan Gaughan just flipped right over.
It's like the nose of that Chevrolet just can't quite push him straight. It just can't do it.
Yeah, the 17 goes up to side draft. I don't think that affects the 18. It's the one just pushing his brother. It peels the 18 off to the right. It looks a lot like the 24 accident. Look at the 62, a full flip back on its wheels, thank goodness. Instantly stopped the flipping, put the car back in position. But a huge, huge accident.
Half apart now from.
Two laps remaining. Back into the restart zone. Green flag back in the air. Ryan Blaney, a great restart.
All right, he's clear of the 10. Slowly moves down in front of the 10.
put the Dillon boys out on the outside lane. Tell you what Pop Pop telling them to do.
Can they get together? That's the problem right now. It's just two against the field.
Yeah, the problem for Blaney is his health did not get clear. But now that 34 gets a great push to the 10. Into the back of the 12. Inside line, all four. There's Stenhouse.
Here comes the 11 of Denny Hamlin as well, the Daytona 500 winner.
All right, we know the Fords can tandem. Will they try to get that going here?
Ty Dillon dropping back in the 13. Coming back on one to go.
And a lot of questions about where position do you want to be in? Do you want to be leading or in second? I think you have to be leading. There's always a wreck with one to go, and then the race is over. So I think Blaney's got to be in this position.
Chase Elliott jumped down the line. That was his, likely his only opportunity, as he's going to get almost three wide there with the 13.
Tries to get help. He tries to get that help from Ty Dillon.
Now,
everyone fighting for every position. Down the backstretch for the final time.
Ryan Newman.
Huge push from Hamlin.
Here comes Newman.
Unbelievable finish.
Yes, we did beat him regardless.
Blaney, by just a foot, is going to get the win over Newman.
7/1000ths of a second that may have saved Ryan Blaney's season. The sixth closest finish in Talladega history, Ryan. How in the world did you A, see the momentum, and B, block it?
There was no blocking the 6 and the 11. They were coming so fast, and I figured I'd give up the bottom, and they were just going to leave me in the middle. So I just decided to stay with Eric. He was a great pusher all day, and I kind of went up and pulled the 11 off the 6, and then he was so far out in front. Then we kind of got together on the front, and he kind of pushed me below the yellow line. I wasn't going to go below there after what happened in the truck race, and kind of got forced down and just worked out. So proud of his team, man. Just survived the last couple days, and hopefully that was an exciting finish. Thank you guys for sticking around. Appreciate it.
You treat these fans to an awesome finish. These playoffs are all about these big moments, Ryan. Talk to me about just the adrenaline in the final few laps, because you guys came in almost a must-win situation.
Yeah, pretty much. I know a lot of guys had their problems today, but we had a problem last week, a bad problem, and we knew we kind of been saying all week, we've been wanting to win races all year, and why have any different mindset? So no matter what spot we're in, but yeah, this was a huge, huge race for us. Man, I'm pumped up, man. I don't know what to say, but thank you, Dent Wizard. Thank you, Menards. Everything these guys do. It's cool. We're moving on. Pretty good.
Going on to the round of eight. How about that, Talladega race fans? Delivered the sixth closest finish ever today. Ryan Blaney is moving on.